Alleluia to your holy name. Let's all believe and shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Blessed be the wonderful name of Jesus. Let every living soul glorify the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Okay, wherever you are right now, put your hands together for the Lord. Let's give him a praise. Let's give him a praise this morning. Let's worship. Let's thank the Almighty God from everlasting to everlasting. You are King, Lord. We thank you, who is like unto thee, O Lord, among the gods. Thank you, Father. Lord, bless us as we go through your word this morning. Lord, we give you praise. We thank you for your divine protection over our lives. We thank you for the spirit of courage you have given unto us, and of love and of sound mind. We give you praise. Oh Lord, bless us through your word today. You speak through your vessel. Oh Lord, I submit myself as the pen of the ready writer to deliver your word. Have your way, Lord. We give you praise. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Praise the Lord. Good morning, good morning, good morning, everybody, wonderful children of God all over the world. We appreciate you. We thank God for your life, and we give God the glory. The Lord is great. The Lord is awesome. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. In these past few weeks, we have seen the mighty moving hand of the Almighty God. He is the Almighty God. He is the Rose of Sharon. He is the reason why we live, why we have our beings. He is the Almighty God. In him we live and move and have our beings. He is the Alpha, the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end. We thank the Almighty God. Blessed be his holy name. Thank God for his divine protection over every home. Thank God for his divine protection over the church as a whole. Thank God for mercy that is walking through the four corners of the earth right now. I see the hand of healing moving around the world. Praise the Lord. Blessed be the name of Jesus. And today, by the special grace of God, what the Lord has laid in my heart, we are going to pray. And the hand of the Lord will reach out to you wherever you are. Just stay prayerfully with me as we go this morning. Blessed be the name of the Lord. This, I think, is the seventh Sunday under this lockdown. But I give God the glory. The word of God was never locked down. The grace of God in our life was never locked down. The favor of God was never locked down. We are enjoying the very presence of God. I'm going to be talking about the presence of God this morning. And next Sunday also, I'm going to be talking about the presence of God. But I am sent to you today. The prophecy, as I have received from the Almighty God, is to tell you, fear not, because the Lord God is with you. Praise the Lord. Power above the storm. This is what we are going to be looking at today, and that is the word that the Lord has given. Blessed be his holy name. Praise the Lord. The Lord has instructed me through his prophetic declaration this morning to tell everybody under the sound of my voice, it is time for you to step out and walk. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. At the comfort of your home, lift up your voice and shout hallelujah. God says there is no more stagnation for you. There is no more stagnation. You are going to step out and walk. Your faith will rise. Favor will rise on your behalf. God is about to do something great in the name of the Father and of the Son of the Holy Ghost. We are going to see how to understand the power of his presence, and we're going to learn how to offset comfort zone, and we're going to step out at his word and walk over the storm of life. You are going to walk over the storm of life. Can I ask you to do something as we are starting? Just take a step of faith, because we are rebuking fear today and we are demonstrating the power of courage. Hallelujah. Take a step of faith and walk. Say, I walk over the storm of life. Begin to walk over it. Walk over it. David says, even though I'm passing through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for thou art with me. Take a step of faith forward and say, progress. I'm making progress. I am moving forward. In the name of Jesus, as you are doing so, you are moving forward. I want you to say it. Get out of the room. Come out of the room. Stand up on your bed and begin to take a step. Walk through the length and breadth of your living room right now, because the church has come to your home. The church is now in your house. The church is now at the comfort of your home. Come and walk around. Take authority right now. Wherever the sole of your feet shall tread upon, the Bible says it's given unto you. So I am walking confidently, and I can say, even though I'm passing through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for thou art with me. The presence of God is what makes the difference this morning. I want you to say, I'm taking over. Take over the blessing of the land. Take over the joy of the land. Take over the supplies of the land. I am taking over. Wherever you are hearing me right now, begin to take over. Step out and walk in the mighty name of Jesus. There is power in spoken word. If you can declare it this morning, it will come to pass in your life. Take over that blessing. Take over the favor. Get rid of the storm. Walk over the storm. You have been given power. You have been given joy. You have been given authority. Authority over the storms of life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The raging storm that is going on all around the world right now, the COVID-19, the coronavirus storm, I call it a storm, and it has come and it is going away. I see it passing away in the mighty name of Jesus. You will live to share the testimony in the name of Jesus. I have seen the mercy of God walking through the hospitals right now. As I hear, I speak, children of the Most High God, I have seen the mercy of the living God. He's walking through all the hospitals around the world. Those who are programmed for death will now receive life. Life is coming to everybody. Life is coming to every home. Life is coming to every church. Life is coming to every social gathering. Life is coming into every system right now. Life is coming into governmental administration. Life is coming into medical system. Life is coming everywhere. I have seen the mercy of God. I have seen the finger of mercy. I have seen the word of God coming to pass. I have seen that Lord Jesus Christ releases mercy, and this mercy is going to enter every home. The mercy is coming into your home. The mercy is coming into your houses. It's coming into your businesses. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, I have seen the mercy of God over our young ones, over our sons and daughters all around the world. I have seen the mercy of God. It takes the power of God. Can I tell you this? It is only God that can cure COVID-19. It is only the Almighty God, and I have heard His voice saying, I will rise and deliver my people. Oh, God rules in the affairs of man. The heart is the Lord and the fullness thereof. Therefore, He is rising now to defend His property. He is rising now to defend the work of His hand. He is rising now. So I speak to you today, fear not in the mighty name of Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord. You are going to step out and walk. Why? Because there is no sinking in His presence. Lord, have mercy. There is no sinking in the presence of God. I want you to say it confidently. Say, there is no sinking in the presence of God. Say, there is no sinking in His presence. Tell the person sitting close to you, there is no sinking, mama. There is no sinking in His presence. No sinking. And I want you to say it like I'm saying it right now. I will not sink in the name of Jesus. I will not sink in the ocean of COVID-19. I will not sink in the ocean. In the ocean of fear, in the mighty name of Jesus. No sinking in His presence. I am sent to tell you today, children of the Most High God all over the world, it may be tough right now, but I can see a good time coming ahead. A glorious time is ahead. A laughter time is ahead. You are going to rejoice. You will laugh. You will laugh best in the name of Jesus. You will rejoice. In fact, He sent me this morning to tell you, begin to rejoice even now. Rejoice always, and I say rejoice. That is the word of God. There is no sinking in His presence. Hallelujah. We're going to be studying in Matthew chapter 14 from verse 22 to 32 today. This is an account of the children of God, the apostles of the Most High, when Jesus, after ministering to several thousand people, feeding them, He asked them to cross to the other side. And while they were going, Jesus wasn't with them at that time, and there was a great storm, and they saw him walking on the water, and Peter said, "If it is you," and they were all afraid. And then Peter said, when he told them, "Don't be afraid, it is me, it is the leader coming," and Peter said, "If it is you, tell me to come." And Jesus told him, "Come," and he began to go, and he was walking on the water. I love that man. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus on that day. I want to see Apostle Peter and say, well done, because he tried and walked on waters. If you don't know how powerful what he has done, if you don't know how powerful it is, tomorrow go and walk on things and come and tell me what you see there. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Let me quickly summarize what the Lord is revealing to us in this very powerful chapter. Matthew 14, 22-32. Christ's presence is assured by personal preparation. You want to experience the presence of God, you've got to prepare for it. Praise the Lord. What makes the difference between us and those who are in the hospital right now is still the same thing, the presence of God. It is not your power that you are alive today. It is not your power that you are not on sick bed. It is not just because of your holiness. It is by his grace. Come on, let's praise him. Let's praise him for his grace. Let's praise him for his power. His presence conquers fear. So many, there is a lot of fear going out right now. The fear of the unknown, the fear of uncertainty, the fear of what may happen anytime, the fear of, I don't know whether I have touch that thing. But if the presence of God is there and you are conscious of the presence, there is no fear. You will not be afraid. I have been sent to tell you today that fear has been destroyed. You will not be afraid. You will not be afraid, for the Lord God is with you. Christ's presence steers the hope of deliverance. We know that even though there is a lot of things going on out there, we have a God. We have the Lord Jesus Christ, the deliverer. He's the savior of mankind. That is why we don't have to be afraid. If we have Jesus in our life, then there is no fear. If there is no Christ, there will be crisis. Because there is Christ, there will be no crisis. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, don't be afraid. Fear not, for the Lord God is with you. In the name of Jesus, his presence conquers nature. Whatever things that the coronavirus or COVID-19 pandemic is troubling the whole world right now. Yes, but everybody is trying. The medical team, they are trying. Honestly, we are praying every minute for them. But I want to tell you something. It takes the mercy of the Lord Jesus Christ to get rid of this thing. And my joy right now is that the Lord is in control. God is in control. This thing you see or hear today, this coronavirus, in the name of Jesus, it will become a thing of the past. It's going to become a history very soon. In the mighty name of Jesus. And in the future, we'll be able to tell the story to all the children yet unborn right now. There was a time that something called COVID-19. It came, but God preserved us, and we went through it. The Lord that has brought us this far will see us through. In the mighty name of Jesus, Christ's presence tears confession and worship. We are going to, a day is coming, church. Hear me well. A day is coming all over the world, in all the churches of the Lord Jesus Christ. A day is coming that people will gather together, every tribe and tongue. We gather in his presence, and we are going to glorify the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. Can I tell you something? You will be one of them. You will be one of the people that will come together and worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Blessed be his holy name. May the Almighty God strengthen his people in the mighty name of Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. We give God the glory because he is worthy of our praise. There are one thing I want us to know today. Fear is a terrible thing. God wants to dispel fear this morning and want to instill courage into us. How are we going to do it? Understand that God is working on your issues. You want to learn the concept of his presence. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's begin to read this scripture from Matthew 14, verse 22. Immediately, Jesus made the disciples get into the boat and go on ahead of him to the other side. And while he dismissed the crowd, after he had dismissed them, he went up on a mountainside. He didn't go into the boat straight. He went on the mountainside by himself alone to pray. That simply means the disciples were ordered to get into the boat and cross to the other side. Praise the Lord. And Jesus was not with them. When evening came, he was there alone. He went there in the afternoon. Up to the evening, he was there. That means the disciples have traveled many hours on the waters before problems started. Verse 24, but the boat was already a considerable distance from the land. Can you see that? A considerable distance from the land. So also, the boat of this year, 2020, has got a considerable distance from the beginning of the year. And right now you are in the month of May, and you began to speak to yourself, Lord God, this is not how I planned this year to be. I thought by this time of the year, in the month of May, this is what many of us will have done. That there's nothing bad in doing that. By the month of May, I would have done this, I would have done that, I would have done this. Nobody is able to think or remember all those stuff right now. All what everybody is thinking of is, Lord, just get me out of this storm. Lord, just get me out of this storm. When I look at people, when they go around, you either kick yourself by the leg or you hook your elbow. That is not how we used to greet ourselves before. We shake hands, so everybody is afraid to shake another person's hand right now. Can't you see? We begin to practice fear where there is no fear. But definitely we have to follow the instruction. Why? We are following in the instruction of the government right now. And many a times we ignore the instruction of the living God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Now, but the boat was already a considerable distance from land, offended by the waves, because the wind was great against it. The wind was contrary against it. The wind of coronavirus is very contrary right now. And you know it just as I knew it, that so many lives have been lost in this. But I give God the glory. As I told you in the beginning, I have seen a great vision. I have seen the mercy of the Lord Jesus Christ walking around in the hospitals. God is going to put a stop to death in the name of Jesus. Life is coming instead of death in the mighty name of Jesus. Verse 25, during the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went out to them, walking on the lake. So Jesus was walking. These people were already in the middle of terrible fear. And then they saw an image coming towards them. It has added to their fear because they didn't know it was in the dark. And they never knew who's coming. And they thought this is another ghost coming. One problem, that is the wind. Another problem, the fear of sinking into the water. Another problem with this ghost coming. When the disciples saw him walking on the lake, they were terrified. It is a ghost, they said, and cried out in fear. But verse 27, but Jesus immediately said to them, take courage, it is I. Don't be afraid. This is the condition. This is the very situation that so many people are today. Fear on every side. There is torment on every side. As a matter of fact, some people are almost dying not of coronavirus right now, but of fear. Some are dying before the actual death. Why? Because the faith in them has vanished or is speedily diminishing. But this morning the Lord has sent me to tell you, listen to the word of God. Pick up your courage. That thing is not going to reach you. In the mighty name of Jesus. And Jesus said, yeah, it is I, don't be afraid. The same word he's speaking to all the four corners of the earth, whether you are Christian or whatever, you are God's handwork. Praise the Lord. And the Lord has sent his word. He has asked me to tell the whole world today. And here, as I hear, I speak, I declare, the Lord is there. The Lord is with you. Jehovah Shammah has taken over this matter. He alone that can solve this problem has taken over the matter of COVID-19. The Lord God Almighty, he has the solution to every problem. He is the Almighty God. And he said, don't be afraid. So I speak to you today. You don't have to be afraid. Whether you have somebody who is affected by this problem, and then you have terrible fear in your heart, he sent me to you today. Fear not, for healing is coming. Don't be afraid if your work has been affected. Fear not, God is going to provide in the mighty name of Jesus. It is time for us Christians to offset our comfort zone and step out of this world and walk over the storm. You will walk over the storm of life in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And then Peter said, Lord, if it is you, Peter replied, tell me to come to you on the water. Come. Verse 29, he said, then Peter got out, he got down out of the boat, walked on the water, and came towards Jesus. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. When Jesus said, come, there is power in the word of God. Remember, in the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. So every word that comes out of the mouth of God must be respected. Every word that comes out of the mouth of God is power. And so when the word comes, has been released by the Lord Jesus Christ, it gives power, it gave power to Peter to start walking. He began to do what Jesus did. Jesus walked on water confidently, and then Peter also came. He stepped out of the boat. He stepped out of fear. He stepped on the waters. He overcame. He overpowered. He stepped over the problem of their life. That praise God. So he began to walk towards Jesus. There is power in the word come. Matthew 11:28. Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. This is the word of God. And the same word is coming to you today. Are you at the junction of confusion? The Lord Jesus is calling you to come. Are you at the junction of fear? He asks you to come this morning. Are you at the junction of sickness? He is calling you. Just come to him. If you can come to him, remember here, the scripture says he was going towards the Lord Jesus Christ. I want you to change your focus this morning. There is no salvation elsewhere. Acts 4:12 says so. No salvation elsewhere, because there's no name that is given under the sun among men through whom we can be saved. It is the name of Jesus. And the Lord God has given him a name that's above every name. At the mention of the name of Jesus, every name shall bow. Every knee must bow. Today, every knee will bow before you in the mighty name of Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord. You are going to do, you're going to stay focused without fear and doubt. You don't have to doubt. Watch this. When Peter was focusing on the Lord Jesus Christ, he did the exploit. He himself was walking on the water, the same thing that Jesus did. Matthew 14:30. Now, let's see. But when he saw the wind was there when he was walking. The wind was there before Jesus came. The wind was there when Jesus came. The wind was there. When we heard the word, it is I. Don't be afraid. The wind was there when he was told to come. When he ignored the wind, he was going on the water. What are we saying this morning? Children of the Most High God, I want you to ignore all those things that want to create an atmosphere of fear for you. Stay focused on the Lord Jesus Christ. If you have not believed before, give your life and believe today. If you have not learned how to trust him before, trust him the more today. If you have been trusting the Lord before, go higher in your trust. Have an implicit trust under the Almighty God. If you have not believed in prayer before, it works in the name of Jesus. You will begin to come upon his name, and he will answer you. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Verse 30, but when he saw the wind, he was afraid and beginning to sink. He cried out, Lord, save me. If you are at this junction right now, cry out unto the Almighty God. I bless the Almighty God. God showed me a revelation. I saw people crying out unto the Lord. I saw people praying at the different corner of their rooms. You know it yourself, how much you have been, how long you have been praying since this COVID-19, it has changed your prayer life totally. And I want us to keep that fire burning. It shall be well with us in the mighty name of Jesus. So Peter called when he began to sing. He called upon the Lord and he said, Lord, save me. The same thing today. I knew that Peter here, well, actually, he was sinking down in the water. But to me, as the Spirit has led me, as the revelation I touched there, Peter was not actually sinking in the sea. He was sinking in the ocean of fear. Peter was sinking in the ocean of fear. What is that ocean that you are sinking in right now? Maybe the ocean, your own is the ocean. You begin to sink in the ocean of financial difficulty. Fear not. The Lord is going to solve your problem out. He's going to sort you out. Jesus is there. Remember, no matter how turbulent the storm is, once the Lord is there, you don't have to be afraid. He will not let you sink. I speak with the authority of the King of Glory. Whatever sea you are sinking in today, God is there. The Lord Jesus there is there. He's going to deliver you. You will not sink. I say you will not sink. If you are finding yourself in the ocean, in the ocean of scarcity today, you will not sink in it. In the mighty name of Jesus, I want you to say, I am coming out. In the name of Jesus, you are coming out of this. You will come out of this. You will come out of the dilemma. You will come out of the storm. In the mighty name of Jesus. In this COVID-19 sea, you will not sink in it. You will not sink in it. Even those people that are in on bed in the hospital, they will not sink in it. God will bring healing. God will bring power. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. When he cried unto God, Lord, save me. There is power in that word. Lord, save me. I want you to say it. Lord, save me. Lord, save our nation. Lord, save the whole earth. In your mercy, save the whole world. The Lord can do it. He can save us. Look at the first word in verse 31. The Bible says, immediately he cried, Lord, save me. Jesus did not waste the next second. Immediately, Jesus reached out. There is no matter what the distance between you and Christ, he will get you. He is going to get you. His hand is mighty. How mighty is the hand of the living God? His throne is in heaven. The heart is his footstool. You can imagine how long the hand will be. So that no matter what the distance, whether your faith is a little bit far away from God, whether your faith is not even there anymore, if you can cry this morning, Lord, save me, the hand of the Lord will deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus. When whatever ocean you find yourself in the ocean of fear, you will not sink. In the ocean of lack, you will not sink. You will not sink in the ocean of poverty. You will not sink in the ocean of coronavirus. You will not sink in the ocean of lack. You will not sink in the ocean of terror. You will not sink in the ocean of the attack of the enemy. You will not sink in any ocean. You will not sink in the ocean of scarcity. You will not sink in the ocean of emptiness. You will not sink in the ocean of chaos. You will not sink in the ocean of darkness. You will not sink in the ocean of the hands of the enemy. You will not sink. 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 Oh, you will not sink. The church is marching on, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. I can see the rebirth of the church. I can see it coming. I see glory of God manifesting in your life. I see glory of God manifesting in your life. I see you rising above the storm. I see the Spirit of the Lord raising a standard against the storm of your life, against this COVID-19, against whatever problem, against the sin and unseen problem. I see the power of God. I see the mighty anointing of the living God writing a new thing, doing a new thing, opening a new door. Opportunities are coming your way. You shall not die, but live to declare the power of God. You shall not die, but live to declare the works of the living God. You will live to share testimony. You will become a distribution center. You will become a testimony. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost, somebody shout fire! Oh, hallelujah! Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. You see, there is power when you call for the help of God. There is some faith in the cry. Help me, Lord. He turned to the Lord Jesus Christ. He removed his hands from the raging storm, from the moving water. He faced the Lord and he cried for help. What are you doing this morning? Romans chapter 10 verse 13. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. This is the time for the church to wake up. Let us wake up and call upon the name of the Lord. And then watch this before we pray this morning. Don't forget, this morning, the Lord is rebuking every storm of your life. In the name of Jesus, whether yours is the storm of hunger, the storm of lack, the storm of the fear of how am I going to do it? How will I bounce back? How will I stand? How will this business rise again? That's a storm. But I declare by the power of the living God upon my life, that storm is over. Can I hear your amen? Lord, I declare, this storm is over in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost. You will return. You will return to the church. You will return to the church. Church, A day is coming when all of us are coming back. We are coming back to the presence of God. I see that day coming. It's going to be a glorious day. No single ear on anybody's head will drop. God is going to protect us. The first service on Sunday, when the church comes back, is going to be an awesome Thanksgiving service. It's going to be a glorious service. And you are going to be among the people that will come up here to share testimony. All over the world, testimonies will be shared. In the mighty name of Jesus, watch what they did. Return to your ship with Christ and the storm will cease. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Verse 32, and when they climbed into the boat, the wind died down. When Jesus, the word they here means the Lord Jesus Christ himself, blessed be his holy name, and who? Peter. Praise the Lord. When both of them stepped into the boat, it means Jesus held his hand, put Peter's hand in his abbey, and then they were walking along. Both of them walked on water. Peter, after he was about to sink and call God for help, he got the help and he was able to walk again. People didn't take note of that. He walked again back into the boat because he has walked a little bit away from the boat before he began to sink, isn't it? There are so many people who had very strong faith before. And at the beginning of the coronavirus, the veil from their faith was removed. They now have faith. And after that, after some time, the faith began to faint. So many Christians are fainting right now. This is the truth. So many people are full of fear, as if tomorrow, the next minute, they don't know what is going to happen. Yes, that's the problem of the whole world right now. But one thing is clear, the presence of Jesus. What makes the difference here? The presence. Peter himself was a human being. He can be afraid. It can happen to anybody. Whatever situation you find yourself right now, if you are afraid, it's not a crime right now. It's just a conventional thing that can happen to mere mortal. But by the grace of God, because of the presence, that is what makes the difference. We are no different from anybody. What is the difference is the power that stands with you. To some people, it is not the power of God that is standing with them. But to you and I, we have confidence that the Lord Jesus Christ is with us. Amen. Amen. If you believe that, shout amen.
Amen.
If you believe that, shout amen.
Amen.
The time is coming very soon. Return to your ship. First of all, return to your God in your home right now. Believe that God has power over the problem. Believe that God is already working on this problem called COVID-19. God is already working and God is going to solve the problem. It is God and God alone, and I believe he will do it. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So both Peter and Jesus, the Lord, they entered the boat. Now, that simply, the Bible says, when they entered and when they climbed into the boat, the wind died down. Watch this. It means all the few minutes it took them to walk from where he caught Peter, and to enter into the boat, the wind was still working. It was when they entered the boat. Are you getting something this morning? It was when they entered the boat that the wind stopped. Jesus did not bother himself. Let the wind continue to do their mess. But you just stay with me and let us go. Praise the Lord. If he likes, he can tell the wind, be still. And the wind has no option than to obey. If he likes, he allowed them to put their mess together and all to demonstrate their folly. And there is nothing that will happen to you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The difference, church, the difference is his presence.
Hallelujah.
His presence. You will not lack the presence of God.
Amen.
You will not lack the presence of Jesus. You will not lack the presence. That's why David, he knew the greatness of the presence of God. And he said, even though I am passing through the valley of death, I shall fear no evil, for thou art with me. The Lord is with you. Jesus is with you. The Prince of Peace is with you. Throughout and forevermore. Throughout this coronavirus pandemic, the Lord Jesus Christ is with you and is with you forever. In the name of Jesus, where the Lord is, the Bible says there is freedom. Where the Lord is, there is liberty. Where the Lord is, there is comfort. There is healing. There is no fear. Where the Lord Jesus Christ is. So he sent me to you today. Fear not. There is no sinking in his presence. In the name of Jesus. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So they came into the boat, ladies and gentlemen. They came into the boat to meet others there. And the moment they entered into the boat, the wind ceased. The wind died down. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Because you have called Jesus into your life and you allow him to take you into the boat, I command in the name of Jesus, every storm troubling your life will be calm. The wind will die in the name of Jesus. The storm will cease. The storm is over. The storm is over. The storm is over. The storm is over. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost. And when the storm is over, fear is taken away and peace is restored. John chapter 14 verse 27. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. I do not give you as the world gives. Do not let your heart be troubled and do not be afraid. Ladies and gentlemen, remove fear from your life. Replace it with courage and faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. You have nothing to fear. The Lord God is with you. You have nothing to fear. The Lord God is with you. And always maintain confession and worship. Verse 33. Then those who were in the boat worshiped him, saying, truly, you are the Son of God. Everybody will worship God with you. When you are sharing testimony, everybody will be there. You will acknowledge Christ as the Son of God in the mighty name of Jesus. They said, truly, you are the Son of God. And the Bible says in Matthew chapter 10, verse 32, whoever acknowledges me before men, I will also acknowledge him before my Father in heaven. Jesus Christ wants you to demonstrate the image of Christ. How do we do that? Tell everybody that the Lord is with me, the Son of God. Hallelujah. Luke chapter 12 verse 8. I tell you, whoever acknowledges me before men, the Son of Man will also acknowledge him before the angels of God. Hallelujah. Let people know that there's Jesus Christ in your life. Let them know that you carry the light of God. Don't be shy to tell people that Jesus is Lord. Evangelism is what everybody must be doing right now. Do it online. Send WhatsApp, send text to people, encourage people, bless them if you can, bless them spiritually, bless them materially, and that is the work that God wants us to do. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. The presence of God is the answer. The Lord Jesus Christ's presence is the answer. Matthew 14, 32, and when they climbed into the boat, the wind died down. Are you with the Lord Jesus Christ right now? Is he right? Are you following his footsteps? Are you going in his direction? Are you entering the boat of life together? You will not sink in the storm of life. And I pronounce today, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost, you will rise above the storm. You will rise above the storm. There is power above the storm. Jesus Christ is the power above it. He is the power above coronavirus. He is the power above every epidemic. He is the power above every pandemic. He is the power above every fear. He is the power above every torment. The Lord God is with you. The very present hell in time of need. His name is Jesus. He is the Prince of Peace. He is the Counselor. He is the Almighty God. I declare the authority of the King of Glory. As I hear, I speak, I see power of God walking through the hospitals, commanding healing in the name of Jesus. I pray for all our doctors and nurses. I command the power of God to divine supernatural protection upon their life in the mighty name of Jesus. Now I release the blessing of God. Oh, the anointing of power about the storm to rest upon your life in the name of the Father. You will not lack any good thing, and the church will rise. The church is marching on, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Whatever you are going through, whatever torment you are going through, whatever problem that is trying to stand before you, who are they? that whole mountain before Zerubbabel, thou shalt be leveled. I command solution to that problem right now in the name of the Father. Nothing will frighten you. You will not be afraid, for there is nothing the enemy can do for you. They will come one time, and because of the presence of Jesus, they are going to run away seven times. What are those things that is being difficult for you right now? The Lord is bringing solution. If it is supply, He will make. I know that my God shall supply all your needs according to His riches and glory by Christ Jesus. Praise the Lord. Philippians 4:19. And I know that what the Lord has started in your life, He will accomplish it. Philippians 1:6. God is going to finish what He has started in your life. You have seen the beginning of this coronavirus. You will see the end of it. You will see the end of it. You will become a testimony. Rise up on your feet wherever you are. You are going to see the end of it. You will tell the testimony. Stretch forth your two hands as I pray. I command the power of the Lord in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. The power that saw Peter through will see you through. There is no sinking in the presence of God. There is no sinking for the children of God. You will not sink in this ocean. You will not sink in the ocean of coronavirus pandemic. You will not sink in the ocean of problem. You will not sink in the ocean of calamity. You will not sink in the ocean of sorrow. You will not sink in the ocean of trouble. You will not sink in the turbulence of sickness. You will not sink in the ocean of poverty. You will not sink. You will not sink. Your children will not sink. Your family will not sink. You will not sink in it. You will not sink in the ocean of the attack of the enemy. You will not sink in the mighty name of Jesus. You will not sink in the ocean of failure. You will not sink in the ocean of darkness. You will not sink in the ocean of intimidation. You will not sink in the ocean of terror. You will not sink in the ocean of the ongoing raging storm. I declare, I command silence. I command the storm, COVID-19 storm, to remain silent and be still, to wipe out in the name of Jesus. I command peace of God, peace in God, peace with God. Rest upon your life. Every desire of yours shall be granted. You will become a testimony. You are coming to the presence of God. Very soon, very soon, very soon, very soon, very soon, very soon, with mighty testimony. Very soon, testimony over your children. Very soon, testimony over your life. Very soon, you are coming back into the presence of God. And you, the Lord will answer our prayer. As you call upon the name of the Lord, in the corners of your room there, God will answer your prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your presence. It is your presence that makes the difference. Wherever Jesus is, there is no sinking. You will not sink. You will not sink. There is no sinking in his presence. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And if you have not given your life to Jesus, by chance you are just listening to me right now, I command in the name of Jesus, the favor of God will be upon your life. And I ask you to surrender your life right now to the Lord Jesus Christ, so that not only are we sure of the blessing here on earth, we are sure of eternity. The certainty of the kingdom of God, the coming of the Lord is very soon. Very soon the Lord Jesus Christ is coming. Let all Christians begin to get ready. Prepare your mind, your family, your home. The Lord Jesus Christ is going to take us home. We will not sink in the ocean of the problem of this world. The world is a global money right now, but I command the joy of the Lord. The joy of the Lord. The joy of the Lord. Lift up your hands and say, I will not sink in the ocean of this COVID-19. Say, I will not sink in the ocean of trouble. In the name of Jesus, I will not sink. You will not sink. Your home will not sink. Your marriage will not sink. The children will not sink. Your career will not sink. Your life will not sink. Oh, come and let's praise Him. Praise Him. Praise Him. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh, Lord, we give you praise. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless His holy name. I sing, bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless His holy name. He has done great things. He has done great things. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
There is no sinking in His presence.
Yes.
We will not sink.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let's put our hands together for the Lord. Lord, we thank you. Lift up your water. And as we are doing this, I'd like to appreciate all the people joining us all around the world. We thank you. May God bless you. Pastor Massa from India, we appreciate you. God bless you. And all our people that joined from the United States, God bless you. People from Nigeria, God bless you. And all the people, all our wonderful people here in London, the Lord bless you real good. Hallelujah. May the Lord bless you. Amen. It's going to be a great week. The Lord will release His peace and His blessing, because He has taken away your fear.
Amen.
Your provision, your supply, everything will come intact.
Amen.
Let us just trust in the Lord. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus,
amen,
according to your instruction, we are lifting up this water. We command the finger of mercy of the Lord Jesus Christ to be upon it.
Amen.
Let this water become miracle working water.
Amen.
As you are putting this water on your table, or you are holding it right now at home, let it receive power.
Amen.
In the name of the Father.
Amen.
In the name of the Son.
Amen.
In the name of the Holy
Amen.
Ghost. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Glorious Lord, I want to pray for special blessing on all the people of the Lord, those who have been supporting, those who are obedient to the instruction of tithes and offering, and they have been doing their very best in this trying time. May the Lord God reward your labor of love. Those that have been trying, I command the blessing of God upon you.
Amen.
You will not lack any good thing.
Amen.
You will never be put to shame.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And to those, some of us who are still putting their mind together to join the group of the obedient this week, may the Lord favor you.
Amen.
You will not lack any good thing.
Amen.
May the Lord favor you.
Amen.
May God bless your business.
Amen.
May God bless everything you lay your hand
Amen.
Upon. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because this is our obligatory nature. It is our responsibility. It is the way we show our commitment to the Lord concerning our church. May God bless you as you
Amen.
Do so. As you do it, He says, prove me if I will not open the window of heaven and pour you. God is going to open the floodgate of blessing.
Amen.
And blessing is coming your way.
Amen.
I see mighty blessing coming.
Amen.
It's about to rain.
Amen.
God will bless your work.
Amen.
Will bless your finances.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let us do it. Let's obey the instruction of the living God. It is His instruction. And when we obey the instruction of the Lord, the blessing of obedience will be ours.
Amen.
May the Lord bless you.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Now, before we go, please, let me repeat the programs during the week on Tuesday, Bible class. And every week, what we are treating right now is the end time events series. We've gone up to part 3 and we are going to part 4. And I believe you see the texts of the Bible, the lesson totally, we sent it to you. On Tuesday morning, the fourth part will be forwarded to you by the grace of God. And also on Wednesday, our faith clinic, that is 1 hour prayer. You can call in, you'll know the number, 0795683271, calling for prayer between 7 and 8 on Wednesday. And also on Friday, 1 hour with God. 1 hour with God, 7 to 8, the same number. May the Lord bless you. We thank the Almighty God for today. May God favor you. This week will bring you blessing.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Sweatless transfer of wealth will come your way. May God give you peace.
Amen.
There is nothing to fear. The Lord Jesus is with you.
Amen.
And there is no sinking.
Amen.
In His presence.
Amen.
Thank you very much today. God bless you for being there. Till this time, next Sunday,
grace.
I say, God bless you.
Amen.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ,
Amen.
The love of God,
Amen.
Fellowship of the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
Abide and be with us,
Amen.
Now and forevermore.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. In Jesus' name. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Amen. Let's shout 3 hallelujah together. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. No sinking in his presence. Amen.